Please be seated. Good morning, friends. My name is Bob Thomson. Our family have been members of the Church of the Epiphany since 1996, when we relocated from San Diego. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to speak with you this morning about why this is our spiritual home. I am the first of a couple of speakers you'll hear over the next couple of weeks to talk to you about stewardship. But today what I'm going to talk to you about is why this place is so special to my family and myself. We have a special place here. We come from all over this country, from other countries as well. We welcome and embrace diversity. That is one of the things that I love about this church. I must admit that I wasn't always the most, diverse person. I thought diversity meant you were just like me, But that's not true. But over the years, I've softened and grown and learned to appreciate and embrace diversity. We have multiple generations represented here. Some lifelong Episcopalians, some recent converts such as myself, some people who are just searching for a spiritual home. Each of us have unique God-given talents. I can't play music like Jay Wilcox. I can't sing like anyone in our choir, nor have I ever been asked to. I can't organize a party like Kimberly Rival or Pam Brunson, and I certainly do not have the patience of Karen James. But I do have one God-given talent. I can get up in front of 100 people or so and share my story, share why this church is so special. When I received a call from Doug Kirby in 1997 to become involved in stewardship, I pretended to know what he was talking about and quickly and eagerly jumped on board. I had no idea what he was speaking about. Coming from the eastern United States, I knew about Stewart's root beer, I knew about Rod Stewart, and I knew about Jackie Stewart, the famous race car driver from Scotland. I didn't have a clue about stewardship, but Doug was very convincing in his own way. After 35 years in corporate America, I recently bought a small business in Camarillo. One of the reasons is that I wanted to become more involved in the local community and spend less time on planes, in hotels, and stuck on the 405. I figured I saved at least 15 hours per week and could certainly pursue some of the things I enjoy or think I would enjoy. I've recently become involved with the Owls Group, working with Michelle Ponticelli. It's a wonderful outreach program we have here. Earlier this week, the Red Door Vineyard hosted a wine tasting event for the Owls. Stacy Stevens, Jamie Pollock, and Vince Castellano represented the Red Door Vineyard and educated the Owls on the finer points of wine in our very own vineyard. It was terrific, and the Owls seemed to really enjoy it. Most, if not all, of the Owls were the original founding members of this church. They had a vision, they had a plan, they dedicated countless hours to see their vision come to reality. And if you look around us and just look at some of the beautiful stained glass windows and the architecture here, this was their vision that they had, some 20 plus years ago. And, I think you have to admit they did a very, very good job. They were the ones who helped raise the money to build this church and start many of the programs which we have today. I feel it is our responsibility, it's my responsibility, to be good stewards of what we have been entrusted with. Why is this place so special? Look around the congregation. Each of us has a special talent or talents. I ask each of you to get involved. We have numerous programs where your God-given talents are needed, and your help is greatly appreciated. Together, we can make a difference and continue to see this church grow and thrive. For those of you who don't know, our church runs on a very slim budget and depends on the financial support of each one of us in order to support our staff, our buildings, and the many programs we offer. Our support is crucial to the ongoing health of this church. Did any of you follow Pope Francis when he was recently on the East Coast? See him? I you're coming from, you know, like Bill, you know, from the middle Atlantic, you know, Philadelphia area, and it's just fascinating to see the Pope amongst those people. I was deeply moved with Pope Francis's visit to the United States. Two things impressed me most. Number one, he was most humble and very simple in the way he lives. For me, if I was ever to be elected Pope, I'd have a Lamborghini as my Pope-mobile, and I would eat at the finest restaurants every night. He has a modest Fiat and eats in the Vatican cafeteria among the custodians. The thing that impressed me the most about him, though, is that when he met in private with some of the most powerful people in this country, during their private conversations, he would always ask them, "Pray for me." I don't know if any of you saw that. It's just very powerful. "Pray for me," in his broken English. Why? Because he prays for all of us and he worries for all of us. So I ask you, before you go to sleep tonight or wherever you say your prayers, say a special prayer for Melissa. Keep her in your thoughts. She prays for us daily. Lord knows she worries about us all the time. That's a full-time job, and she doesn't get paid to worry about us. And that's in addition to her full-time job as our rector here. Pray for this church, this wonderful congregation, and the many blessings we have to be thankful for. Finally, pray for clarity when you decide to financially support this wonderful place and its many valuable programs. God bless, and thank you for